Hello, I'm Jodi Brenner Ginsberg of Ginsberg Law Offices. Today I want to talk to you about a couple of different types of motions that we are filing a great deal of these days when it comes to folks and getting their medical care or getting doctors that we want to get the treatment to come from. There's a 102D motion. Again, this sounds rather technical, but it's what we do, where we are going to list for the judge the facts of what's going on in your case. We're going to many times have an affidavit that we're going to get from our client to attach to that motion, and then we're going to make an argument and citing the law that backs us up to try to convince the judge that the medical care that you need is necessary. There's been a couple of different iterations of the board form 205 is another document that we use where an authorized doctor is trying to get medical care and the adjuster or the opposing counsel is not getting it approved fast enough. So there are definitely different types of ways that we can get it to a judge and hopefully move it along for you as well as ask for a hearing. In addition, there's a WC 200A and 200B motion that we file if we can get the other side to say agree to a different doctor. Let's say we're having a discussion about one doctor is saying this is necessary for your treatment, one doctor is saying that is not necessary for your treatment. We're going to do everything we can to get you to a doctor that's going to be helpful to you. And in many cases, we can negotiate that with the adjuster or their counsel and get it agreed to and then file a motion 200A, which allows us to move it along and get that medical care going. When we cannot get agreement by the other side to a particular doctor, we're going to file a WC 200B motion, and in those circumstances, that's when we're finding that doctors are at odds with each other, and the adjuster and myself, as your lawyer, if I am, is at odds in terms of agreeing to a doctor, or their counsel will not agree, and then we're going to get the evidence in the case, we're going to get the medical records, we're going to point out to the judge why the doctor that we're trying to get for you is the appropriate doctor. We're also going to look to see if there was a proper posted panel of physicians, whether or not it was explained to you, because if those things are not done, it allows us to have stronger arguments to convince a judge that we should be able to select the doctor that's going to be most beneficial to help you with your injuries. So there are a lot of things that can be done to help move the medical along. We're more than happy to speak with you about them. We've been doing this for a very long time and happy to give you some of our knowledge and help you with your case. You can reach me directly at 770-351-0801, and I'll be more than happy to speak with you about it. Thank you. Hi, this is Jodi, and I hope you found this video helpful. If you'd like to know more about all rights and benefits available to you under the Georgia Workers' Injury Laws, I'd like to invite you to download my Georgia Workers' Compensation Survival Kit that I created for folks just like you. Some of the topics I cover include, can I get fired for filing a work injury claim? 8 critical mistakes to avoid. Is it true that the insurance company will hire a private investigator to follow me around and videotape my activities? What happens when the insurance company is late with my weekly wage payments? 7 specific tactics I recommend to maximize your case settlement value. If you or a loved one needs to maximize your recovery from your Georgia workers' compensation claim, you'll find this survival kit important reading. Download your survival kit right now and at no cost. Just visit my website and sign up. It's that easy. Please act now, and as always, I wish you the best.